Cari amici e colleghi, buon pomeriggio. Vorrei ringraziare agli organizzatori di darmi questa opportunità di salutarvi almeno da lontano, visto che purtroppo questa volta non posso essere con voi. I was asked to give you a little bit of background on the work that we have done over the last few years on physical activity promotion policy. Until about 15 years ago, only very few countries had a national strategy to promote physical activity, most notably Canada and Finland. Then in 2004, the Global Strategy on Diet, Physical Activity and Health was adopted by the World Health Assembly, and it called upon countries to develop national strategies to promote diet, physical activity and health. So this really marked the starting point on a global scale for physical activity promotion. However, at the beginning, there was no exchange between countries on successful approaches and no overview on who did what worked and what did not. So at WHO Europe, where I worked at the time, through the HEPA Europe network, we decided to start the development of an inventory on physical activity, and we focused first on collecting national policy documents. This inventory was launched in 2006 on the occasion of the WHO Ministerial Conference on Counteracting Obesity. This ministerial conference, by the way, was the first time that physical activity was an agenda item at such an event. Through online searches and with the help of many experts and colleagues across Europe, we had succeeded in identifying about 50 national policy documents from about 25 countries across Europe. While making these examples available to others to learn from was essential, we were also interested to understand better which elements were important for successful national approaches. So we started a content analysis of these policy documents. To do this, we looked at similar work of others, most importantly, of course, Fiona Bull's early work in Australia, as well as guidance documents developed by the WHO. In the end, we analyzed a set of 8 elements in each of these policy documents. This work provided important learnings. It showed that many elements of good policymaking were adopted, but it also showed that, for example, less than half of the documents mentioned funding or evaluation. Intersectoral collaboration was identified as another weakness in many of these policy documents. While these results gave us first important insight into what was happening across countries to promote physical activity, an important limitation was that we could only look at what the policy documents said, but not what was actually happening on the ground. So we launched a HEPA Europe working group on national approaches and started in 2009 to develop a policy appraisal tool, or PAT, which would allow us to develop a more comprehensive and in-depth overview of national strategies to promote physical activity. The PAT is also collecting information on the existence of national policy documents, but national experts filling it in also add information on what is actually happening on national and subnational level, who is responsible, who is collaborating, and who is doing what and how. This is giving us a much richer insight into the workings of national physical activity policy across Europe. We worked with 7 countries to develop and continuously improve the PAT over the last few years, and now these 7 examples are available, including the one from Italy done by our dear friends Alberto Arlotti and Silvia Colitti. Karen Milton, our colleague involved very closely into this work, is now going to present you selected results with a focus on intersectoral collaboration to open this session. I wish you a fruitful further course and send you best wishes from Switzerland, and I hope to see you all soon. Bye-bye.